Why am I not getting alerts when I think I should be getting them? One of the reasons why monitoring engineers see that alerts show up in their inbox or in their ticket queue later than expected is because you need to understand everything that goes into the entire cycle of an alert. So we're going to use a very simple alert on a very simple monitoring system. We're going to say that we collect CPU details every 5 minutes. We're going to say that we check for an error condition every minute. What we're looking for is CPU over a particular threshold, and it has to be sustained for 10 minutes. So that's what we're looking for, fairly straightforward. We're going to start the clock at midnight, at 12 o'clock. At 12 o'clock, the machine in question is fine. At 12:01, the CPU spikes. Now, I collected my data at 12 o'clock, so I don't know, my monitoring solution doesn't know that the CPU is high. It won't see it until 12:05, which is 4 minutes later. Now, at 12:06, my query that looks for high CPU runs. Now, I'm starting the 10-minute clock. At 12:10, which is only 4 minutes into the 10-minute counter, I'm going to collect my next reading. CPU is still too high, but I'm only 4 minutes in. At 12:15, I'm collecting my next reading. CPU is still high, but I'm only 9 minutes into the 10-minute counter. It isn't until 12:16 that the query runs and says, yep, CPU has been high for 10 full minutes. Now we're going to kick off an alert. But that may be 5-6 minutes later than you expected the problem to be detected because of the polling cycles and because of those other delays. If your monitoring solution doesn't give you the granularity that you need to adjust these settings, you might want to check out SolarWinds NPM. Visit SolarWinds.com and download a free 30-day trial today.